And welcome to the class of mathematics of class 10. And dear students, today we are going to study about real numbers. That is the first chapter in our class. So let us begin. So in real numbers, the first very important lemma that we have to study in this class, that is about Euclid's division lemma. And Euclid was a great mathematician of Greek who gave us this lemma. So to honoring him, this lemma is on the name of that mathematician, Euclid. And so we write here Euclid's division lemma. So that Euclid's division lemma states that for given positive integers, A and B, there exists unique integers Q and R satisfying A is equal to BQ plus R, where R is greater than equal to 0 and less than equal to B. So, for given positive integers A and B, there exist unique integers Q and R such that A is equal to BQ plus R. So, in other way, we can say that we have studied in previous classes, let A be the dividend and B is the divisor, and Q is the quotient and R is the remainder. So we did in previous classes that dividend, this is here dividend, this is divisor, this is quotient, and this is remainder. So in previous classes we read that dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So actually we are writing A is equal to B into Q, that is dividend A, and B divisor into quotient, that is BQ plus R remainder. So actually we are writing this. A is equal to BQ plus R, but conditions are so here. Here is condition that R will be less than, R will be greater than equal to 0 and less than B. It means remainder is always less than divisor. That is the very important condition. Because if this condition is not satisfied, then this statement will not be verified. Like I am giving you one example why this lemma is important. Because due to this lemma we do the division. Like you are dividing 49 by 4. We have to divide. So what do we do? We write here 4 1 ja 4. Now then say here 9. So here, if you are using here division lemma, that is not complete division. Why not it is complete? Because this condition is not satisfied here. That remainder should be less than divisor. Here you are writing 9. 9 is not less than 4. So if you will apply here, dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder, then it will not satisfy. Because here 4 1 is 4, 4 plus 9, 13. But what will here is 49. So this condition is not satisfied and it is also not complete division. So what do we do? Once again, because this is not less than this divisor. So once again we do 4 to the 8 and now 1. Now we see that this is the remainder. This is the remainder because 1 is less than 4. So here if you will apply Euclid division lemma, then it will be 49 is equal to 4 into 12 plus. So here we can say that for two positive integers 49 and 4, there exist integers 12 and 1 such that let it be A, let it be B, let it be Q, let it be R, such that B is equal to AQ plus R. So actually this is the statement. So that we do it in the checking of division, that dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So that actually states Euclid's division lemma. So in this way you can state it, and this is very important because it was due to this Euclid, a Greek mathematician, who gave us in his book Element 7 that lemma. And the students have problem in lemma. So lemma is simple thing. Lemma is what? Lemma is a, it is a proven statement. It is a proven statement which is used to verify other statements. Yes, so we say it is Euclid division lemma because Euclid was a Greek mathematician who gave us this lemma, and it is related to division and it is considered as proven statement. So it is known as Euclid division lemma. So for given positive integers A and B, there exist unique integers Q and R satisfying A is equal to BQ plus R, where R is greater than equal to 0 and less than B. So this is an important condition that we should keep in. Now this Euclid division lemma is used in finding the LCF of numbers. Yes, so in this class we will apply Euclid division lemma and find the HCF. So like two numbers we have to find the LCF of two numbers by using Euclid division lemma. And the number is, so question may be that find the HCF of 225 and 135 by using Euclid's division lemma. So find the LCF of 225 and 135 by using Euclid's division lemma. So sometimes we also take it as a Euclid division algorithm. Algorithm means series of steps that we use to find the solution of any problem. So sometimes Euclid division lemma is also used as Euclid division algorithm. So what we have to do? We have to do to find the LCF of 225 and 135. So what we do? So for 225 and 135 by using Euclid's division lemma, we have. So simply you can do it rough, that 135, you divide 225, 1 times 135, 5 minus 5, 0, square minus 3, 90. So we can write here, for numbers 225 and 135, we can write 225 is equal to, like A is equal to B into Q plus R. So 225 can be written as 135.